94.2 The Edge. Traffic and weather.
NetSafe, keeping you safe online.
Some cloud and patchy showers, mainly fine though today, high of 17. All good on our motorways into the city. The northern, some small delays, Northcote Road to Esmond, 25 minutes Constellation Drive to the city. Northwestern, 25 in from Massey, just a bit slow from Great North. Southern, slow patches, Highbrook Drive to Green Lane, 30 minutes in from Manukau. Southwestern, just a bit slow citybound, Puanui to Massey, fine the other way.
Let's make Aotearoa safe online. Head to netsafe.org.nz for details.
The Edge News Now.
Morning, Mel here from News Hub at 8. Civil Defence is urging people to take care in coastal areas with strong currents possible today. No tsunami threat after an 8.2 quake off Alaska last night, but care is needed at beaches and coastal rivers.
We're not saying people shouldn't visit those areas, but just remain cautious for unusual tides.
Another offer from DHBs, another rejection from nurses. 52,000 members from the nurses' organisation are a chance of walking off the job again next month. A spokesperson says the pay offer was better but didn't value the work they do. A warning not to arrive at the mass COVID-19 vaccination event today without a booking. More than 16,000 people will be getting the jab over the next 3 days in South Auckland. And the games might be going well for competitors, but hosting the Olympics has seen cases of COVID skyrocket in Japan. The country's recorded over 10,000 daily cases for the first time. An official warning, the country is facing its biggest crisis since the pandemic began.
The number of newly infected people is increasing not only in the Tokyo area, but in many other parts of the country. The Delta variant is spreading at a rapid rate never seen before.
And that's Edge News with MTF Finance, helping Kiwis to do more whatever the weather since 1970. T's and C's and lending criteria apply.
The Edge Sports Hit.
A huge comeback from the Black Ferns Sevens team at the Tokyo Olympics, going from 21-0 down to beat Great Britain 29-21. They face Russia today and are expected to be in the quarterfinals tonight. Single sculler Emma Twiggs a hot favourite in her race today at 12:30. The women's and men's eights with genuine chances too, racing just after 1. Tennis stars Michael Venus and Marcus Daniel miss the gold medal match and play for bronze at 3 p.m. And we've got two women in shot put qualification from 10:25 tonight, including Dame Valerie Adams.
The Edge News and Sport with Kogan Mobile, New Zealand's cheapest unlimited prepaid plans.
It's Dom, Meg and Randell on The Edge.
Good morning, it is 4 minutes past eight on your Friday. Final day for our Dom. Two more hours of the Dom, Meg and Randell show. It's a sad day, but also a day of celebration and looking back at the incredible achievement, Dom, that you've completed.
Oh, thanks, team. I haven't cried yet this morning.
You've been on the brink.
I have. Got some of the text messages, they make my eyes water. You know, I think that says a bit about my growth as a person over the last few years. I don't think I cried through my 30s at all. And then, you know, I've seen co-hosts come and go over the years, and when they cry at their farewell thing, I'm thinking, I'm never going to be a person that cries on my last day.
I think you I softened you up a little when you hardened me up.
Maybe. Yeah. We met in the middle.
Yeah.
It's been fabulous. God, I'm going to miss it. I'm not going to miss the early mornings. And Wednesday morning when I announced, I explained my reasons why. But I am going to miss hanging with you guys and the fun we have.
Yeah,
once you're out of bed in here, it's a lot of fun.
But mate, so you've done your last 4 a.m. alarm. That's it. Oh, that's so lucky.
But as I explained the other day, you know, when you play a game of sport, you play like 40 minutes, you have 10 minutes off, and then you play the second half. I'm considering what I'm doing, like a halftime break.
Yeah.
Halftime break.
Jeepers, which means your full-time whistle, you're going to be 96.
Okay.
Is there a station for that?
I don't know. But I've still got a lot of energy, and I've got a lot of passion and love for radio. Yeah. Like radio's in my blood. But I just need a break for me before I return.
Well, it was incredible, mate. The text computer is just like pinging off. So you definitely want to copy and paste all those somewhere and get through them over the next probably couple of weeks.
Yeah, it's really nice.
And we do want to know if you do have any final wishes, Dom. Is there something you've always wanted to do? Is there something that you were planning on doing at some point and then you know, we didn't get to the time, we didn't get round to doing it? Something you've ever wanted to do to Randell, do to me, make us do? I don't know. I mean, I know you don't want to defecate on the boss's desk, but is there something you're like, gosh, if I don't do it today, it's not going to happen? Or if I don't make these two do it today, it's never going to happen?
No. Oh. Ooh.
Was it what, kind of like when you're like death row and you get your final meal?
Oh, final
and you get your
meal.
You get your one wish.
That's a good idea.
Maybe just like one final glance at Randall's D. No, I don't know.
Well, you
oh,
have,
I, I honestly can't think. I can't think. It's been such a ride with you guys. And I feel like I've done everything I want to do.
Do you want to
you want to flop it out?
Yeah, come around here.
Okay.
Come around here. We'll just, where's the live stream? Where's that camera? We'll make sure we're away from that. It's the edge.
Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks. Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world? Good for you, I guess that you've been working on yourself. I guess the therapist I found for you, she really helped. Now you can be a better man for your brand new girl. Getting everything you want. You bought a new car and your career's really taking off. It's like we never even happened, baby. What the f*** is up with that? And good for you, it's like you never even met me. Remember when you swore to God I was the only person who ever got you? Well, screw that and screw you. You will never have to hurt the way you know that I do.
Olivia Rodrigo, it's good for you on the edge. 10 past 8, Dominic and Randell, Dom's final day on the Dominic and Randell show. And your opportunity to jump on the phones, 0800 The Edge, and yeah, just say your thoughts, your best wishes, and someone who wants to kick that off, who I think is very close to your heart, Dom, Zane Nicol.
Oh my God, Zane married Paula in the Edge's very first Two Strangers in a Wedding. This was like a year before I started at The Edge. I was still at my station in Palmerston North.
Yeah.
Zane, good morning.
Good morning. How are we, team?
You're good. Zane and his wife Paula and their one fabulous kids, they're a massive part of the Edge fabric going way back. Like most people listening to the Edge now probably weren't listening when these guys got married.
Well, so you literally, do you ever, Zane, look at your children and go, wow, if the Edge didn't get us two together, these guys don't exist?
Mm-hmm. Every day. No. Every day. Count my lucky stars.
Wow.
No, I don't believe that. Like, it was so long ago that they got married. Like, you know, the thanks for the radio station can only last so long. Like, you guys have thrived on your own.
Oh, yeah. But would you have ever found your...
Met.
Yeah, would you have ever found your wife, do you think, or stumbled across her outside of the Edge pairing you two up?
No, I think I was too dumb when I was looking around for a lady when I was younger, that's for sure. And I needed some sensible people. to hook me up. So, that was good.
Now, here's the amazing thing about Zane and his wife Paula and what they did with two strangers in a wedding. This is like decades before Married at First Sight. So we're all used to the concept now, but this was something brand new, never been done before. There was so much controversy about it. There was a 7 p.m. current affairs show called Homes, and it was on every night with religious people saying it's wrecking the sanctity of marriage. Paula and Zane were under so much heat. The fact that they went through with it and didn't pull out is remarkable on its own. And the fact that they're together now with three kids 21 years later, it's just mind-boggling.
Wow. Well, Zane, we thought we'd pass it over to you because I know you wanted to, wish Dom well, and you've got a few things that you wanted to say. I mean, a lot of people do, but we thought we'd give you the mic first.
Oh, yeah, like, I think the nation was shocked on Wednesday to hear that Dom was had decided that he wanted to do something for himself and do some hit the reset button, which is a bloody great call, mate. Awesome, you obviously needed it. You're like an onion, mate. You know, you've got many, many layers. That brown part that no one likes on the outside that you try and skin off, and you got wet hands and it sticks to your hands and you get really annoyed with it. And then when you start cutting down into the layers, the deeper you go, the more you cry. That's Dom. So, mate, we're gonna miss you. You're an amazing person. You're an integral part of our family. Both Paul and I and all the kids, we just wish you all the best, and we'll always have a wine in Hamilton for you.
Oh, thanks, mate. I really, really appreciate it. It's been great being part of your life.
You're a bloody legend, mate.
Mate, 2 hours, 2 hours, mate. 14, and you got him, Zane. He's
the
tearing
first
up
one to make him cry.
Yeah, what a piece of shit. No, nothing but love, and I'll definitely take you up on that wine offer. I'm going to have so much more time to just
100%, mate.
Reconnect with people in my life that are important, but that you don't see often enough, and that's you and Paula and your kids are definitely in that. Love you guys.
No, you just got a heart of gold, mate, and you know that exterior of yours is softening. That's for sure. Mm-hmm. You're an amazing person, and you've touched so many hearts, and a lot of people are going to miss you every day with just your domness, your humour. You know, this who you are is fantastic.
Oh, well, thank you for taking the time to call, mate. Really, really appreciate it, and I'll be seeing you for that wine soon.
Thanks, Zane.
Thanks,
awesome,
Zane.
Mate.
Thanks, Zane.
I like that. Someone just texted and saying, Dom, you...
Meg, cut him off.
I didn't mean to.
I know, he was done. He was done. Someone just texted and saying, the text has got hard to keep up with all of them, but basically I'm the most annoying person I've ever heard on radio. But, you learn to like me.
Yeah, he's in a quiet taste. If you eat it enough, first you find it awful, and then you're like, you know what, I don't mind that.
Oh, shit, I'm gone. I'm gone.
All right, we'll do a little reset. If you want to... wish Dom well. You can get in touch. 0800 The Edge, and also very soon we're gonna look. Oh, you tell Meg off for doing that. Your mic's still on.
It was a clever radio thing. It's like a sound effect. It proves I've been crying.
Okay. Well, they can just live stream if they want to prove you're crying. Watch the 3343. If you text that, you can see the real tears. We're going to look back. Also, we do a producer's diary on a Friday, and it normally looks back at the week that has been, but actually we're going to look back at the last two decades that have been. It was a mammoth effort from our producer Fipsy, I think, to go back through two decades of highlights, but he's wrapped it all up, and we will get to that in just a few minutes as well as we look back at the incredible career that Dom has had on The Edge. It's Doja Cat in The Weeknd. You right?
Yeah, I'm good.
No, that's the name of the song.
Oh.
You're right.
Damn it, I fell for it.
Yeah. Got ya. It's The Edge, Dom, Meg and Randell. I got a man, but I want you. I got a man, but I want you. And it's just nerves, it's just making me think about someone new. You know that's so much to say. I try to hide it in my face. And it don't work, you see through. That I just want to get with you. And I can't. Up. You can text the word Dom to 3343. It'll send you the video of that announcement and all the different reasons, I think, why you've decided to make this decision for yourself.
Yeah, the timing just seems right. Got so many, it's humbling, isn't it? All the amount of people texting in on 3343 with a nice message.
Who knew we had this many listeners?
I know. What about this one? I've been listening to you from the start, through school to college to work. You've been there each morning. You told me off on text when I called you out in my teens, and from that smarter, I do that sometimes. Eh? If you catch me on the wrong day, you send in a trolling tweet, I will respond.
Man, you are.
I've got better,
you'd be
though.
Lucky if you got a reply from Dom. You know, it's a novelty now. You can't get them anymore. Angry reply from you.
Right.
You're very diplomatic.
Yeah.
Because you know everyone can screenshot everything.
No, I'm saying that because he can't send any more from now.
He's not diplomatic at all.
No, I have.
I've toned down very much in the last couple of years because people will screen cap it and put it on TikTok.
Yeah. Hey, I know tomorrow we have been pushing towards this social football game, but that's only going to be 90 minutes. I would like to see tomorrow be a real party and a celebration of Dom. The three of us will all be there along with the Edge crew and a whole lot of festivities. So if you are in the Auckland area, text the word soccer to 3343 and you can catch up with us and send Dom out in style tomorrow afternoon. But we are about to look back at some of the highlights from the last two decades of Dominic Harvey on the Edge. Are you ready?
Oh, I think so. Meg, have you got more tissues?
Yeah, I do. Okay. I've got plenty.
So how do you even begin to sum up the career of someone who spent 20 years at the Edge?
Well, you've got to go back
to the very start.
Fresh music for Kev and the crew at Camaro Street.
Oh, heck no, not that far back. This song was number one in NZ when Dom first turned on a microphone at the Edge, and since then he's chatted to just about every major celeb you could ever think of.
Hello,
Lady Gaga.
Hi, welcome. Everyone.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Good. Is this Zac Efron?
Yes, it is.
Hi, this is Katy Perry.
God, you're an absolute delight, aren't you?
Nice to meet you.
I think I've fallen in love.
Flirting with her.
No, I'm in love. For you, Katy Perry, I'd drop her immediately.
You are not a nice human being. Okay, I'm done.
Oh my God.
He's interviewed and become friends with the real Tom Cruise.
There's a school we're shooting close to, you know, over the set. It's called Uranui. They've been trying to raise money so that they could have a shelter so the kids could play outside. And I was thinking, if you guys are, you know, can go up to $7,000, can you guys afford that? And I'll match it and we'll help them out there.
And the not-so-real Tom Cruise?
It's actually my good friends, JJ, Dom, and Randell from The Edge.
Okay. Can we call Simon and Gary back or attempt to call them back?
I reckon we let us simmer for a couple of years.
No.
To be honest, he's probably lost count of the number of times he's heard these words.
Crap loads of complaints this morning, so I've got to do something fast.
Did you get crap?
So spend without pay tomorrow.
And these ones too, actually.
Try to keep it from getting too lewd and sexual.
Of course, if you can. Not that that ever stopped him, though.
What terms should we not use, do you think?
You definitely should not use
a pussy.
Grubby
nice.
No, grubby little boy.
Grubby little boy.
Grubby.
This is the best. Over the past 20 years, Dom has done some incredible stuff. He's been buried alive.
He's starting to shovel the dirt onto the coffin.
Oh,
you're probably hearing Dom's microphone as well.
He's skydived.
Oh, how was that, buddy?
Oh, that was insane.
And he's even been to space.
Jeez, that goes so fast.
Not to mention helping spread the love for ginger people right across the world.
Are there any giggers here yet?
Yeah! Wow!
There are. I'll tell you what, I've had a couple of hugs already. There's a good turnout. Gingers and non-gingers. Morning, everybody!
One thing that will always be remembered was in 2018, when he ran 5 marathons in 5 days to save a little girl named Kaulani's life.
Moana, tell us what this will do.
This will make her better, eradicate her disease.
You know, I thought we could use our radio airwaves for some good and maybe help try and make some money just to make things a little bit easier for the family.
Sure.
I had this idea over the weekend, about 5 marathons in 5 days.
Meters to go. Here comes Tom Harvey.
He's
going to
do it.
Tom Harvey has done it. He has done it. 5 marathons in 5 days. What an achievement.
Oh, my God. So, Dom, we salute you, bro. Radio's true king of the one-liner.
Have a happy Valentine's Day, whatever you're doing. Or for the single people, happy Allentine's Day. That's for those listening that won't be getting the V or the D today.
Okay. The man who always puts his body on the line.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh,
it looks so bad. And the guy who isn't afraid to open up to show others that it's okay to.
I thought, starting by just being, open and transparent and vulnerable is the best way to start. And it's just something I haven't done in years,
We're going
to
miss all the parodies.
Still haven't seen Avatar. Still haven't seen Avatar.
And the spaghetti throwing.
Of grabbing your spaghetti that you'd ordered from this lovely Italian restaurant.
Just a handful.
And throwing it out the window of a two-storied restaurant.
I thought, how can I make the evening about me?
And the way you've never been afraid to put people in their place.
First Dom Harvey, who ran over 200 kilometres for a sick girl, told a kid to go F themselves on
Friday.
You
had a fight with a child.
Let's find out how old he is. No, that sounded like a little girl.
Oh, that makes it even worse.
I think you swore at a little girl. They can't take our call. She's still getting ready for primary school. Oh, my God. You're an animal.
And also, just the fact that your wee dog Kanye will always be richer than we could ever dream of being.
I've changed my will.
Oh, no. You have not.
Leave all your money to Kanye.
Ridiculous.
That little Kanye, he's getting the lot.
No. That's
that is silly.
You might be thinking, well, what's he going to do with a late model Holden Commodore? But that's up to him.
Dom Harvey,
we love you, bro.
Producer Pipsy, thanks so much.
Yeah, that was beautiful.
I can't imagine how many hours of your week that took to find those clips and put it together. Thank you so much, mate.
It's all good, bro. You're welcome.
I really appreciate it. I mean, I miss these dudes.
What are you going to call them?
Call them
by what you normally call them.
What do I normally call them?
Little bitches.
Yeah, these little bitches. Yeah, Producer Pipsy, I love you. And Intern Cal, love you too. Going to miss you guys.
Love you, bro.
Yeah. Thanks, guys. But it takes a lot of effort to put that diary together each week.
It does.
Tremendous amount of work. And we only hear it at the same time as you guys. We have nothing to do with it.
Nah. I think he's normally here at about 4 in the morning, Producer Pipsy, and I heard he was still here at 3 or 4 yesterday afternoon.
Wow.
Yeah. God, he must earn heaps.
Well, maybe not as much as you might think.
Can I get paid by the hour?
That would be better.
Yeah, all right, we're going to get to more well wishes of people who want to jump in the air and just tell Dom sort of what the show has meant to them and how it has shaped and changed their life, so we'll get to those. And some very special guests, some blasts from the past as well, joining us in studio between now and 9 o'clock. Said, "Hey, could I get some time?" Including your ex-wife JJ, who was also the reason you ended up on the Edge, because she was like, "Well, I'm only coming if my boyfriend's also allowed to be
that.
On the show."
Yeah, that's
lot
right.
Lot to thank.
That's right.
Yeah, that's so ballsy.
I played the long game. I ended up like marrying her just to get the job.
So we'll be hearing from her as well coming up after the break. We'll get to headlines in 3. Dominic and Randell, you're on the Edge.
These fresh new hits have just been added to the Edge playlist.
Paige, goodbye. Camila Cabello, don't go yet. Lil Nas X featuring Jack Harlow, Industry Baby.
All the fresh new hits on the Edge.
Repco's stock take sale is now on with massive mid-year savings like 30% off car care and 30% off gear oil, brake fluid, auto transmission fluid and additives. This weekend only. Repco, it starts with the parts.
Freshen up inside with these knockdown deals. Save $24 on Accent Losheen 4-litre interior paint, now only $55.98. And Botanicals Collection Boston Ferns, now just $14.97. Big range, low price, local advice, only at Mitre 10.
Better breakfast choices happen all day with Pita Pit Breakfast Pitas. Create your pita with tasty, free-farmed bacon and free-range eggs. Make it your own with fresh fillings ready to get on the grill. Want a better breakfast? Order Pita Pit at pitapit.co.nz.
Get an incredible sleep at an incredible price with the Incredibed. Offering incredible comfort and support, the queen bed is just $999. That's incredible value. And it's proudly made in New Zealand. The Incredibed, exclusive to Harvey Norman.
Sign up to any Vodafone Endless Data $60 or above pay monthly mobile plan and you'll get $60 off over 3 months. Go you! Speeds reduced after max speed data allowance exceeded. Eligibility, fair use and terms apply. Visit Life Pharmacy and earn double points on beauty and fragrance. With a wide range of great brands and offers to choose from, now's the perfect time to shop in-store or online. Only at Life Pharmacy. Hurry in Sunday. T's and C's apply.
For the broad range of job opportunities that other job sites just don't have, go to MyJobSpace. Employers and job hunters are searching at MyJobSpace, the launch site for every Kiwi career. MyJobSpace.co.nz.
Digital marketing, websites, data, analytics. Start with ThatWeb, one of New Zealand's most experienced digital marketing companies. Effective, affordable and guaranteed BS-free. If image is a big part of your business, go to fatweb.co.nz.
Let your taste buds loose at Shed 10. Street Eats 2021, a multi-level food and music festival experience with pop-up kitchens, bars, craft beers, boutique spirits and a huge DJ lounge featuring Sweet Mix Kids, Weird Together Sound System, Rooms, DJ Belleville and DJ Forge. Plus eclectic live performances. Your recipe for a good time. Street Eats on now at Shed 10. Tickets from $20 at the door.
94.2 The Edge. Traffic and weather.
What'smyhousevalue.co.nz.
Some cloud and patchy showers on a mainly fine day. Got a high of 17. Into the city, we're fine on our motorways. Slowest on the southern. Busy traffic. Ellerslie to Green Lane at 30 minutes. Monaco to the CBD. Yeah, and that's our busiest motorway. Northwestern 23 in from Massey. Just a bit slow around Great North and Northern fine. Small delays at Esmond. 20 in from Constellation Drive. Southwestern, bit slow around Mangere Bridge.
Looking to sell your home? Visit what'smyhousevalue.co.nz.
The Edge News Headlines.
Morning, the Director General of Health is defending the time it's taken to revamp the country's mental health system. Advocates are frustrated at the slow progress being made, with concerns about high suicide rates and a lack of support. People in coastal areas of the country are being urged to take care today after a massive quake overseas. An 8.2 shake hit off Alaska last night. And after nearly two decades, talent show The X Factor has been given the axe, with declining viewer numbers to blame. And in sport, two-time gold medalist Eric Murray is predicting another huge day for our rowers at the Tokyo Olympics. He says based on form, we could be on the podium another three times.
The Edge Breakfast, thanks to Rodney Wayne, the hair coloration experts. Here's Dom, Meg and Randall.
It's the Edge, just gone 8:30. A lot of people going to be joining us on the show over the next 90 minutes, wishing Dom well and telling, I guess, us about their favourite stories.
Nice. A lot of people have been texting and asking if Stephen from Dunedin's going to be on the show this morning. I'm just trying to...
I was just going to update you, actually.
Oh, yeah?
I was just popping back in.
Hang on.
You going to call him?
Yeah, the call should be.
At the tone, record your message.
Flight mode, you?
Unfortunately, I don't believe we're going to be able to get Stephen.
Really? He doesn't want to come on? Oh, he'll regret this. He does this. He gets very... Stephen from Dunedin, if you're a long-term listener of the show, you'll know him. The week The Edge got switched on in Dunedin, which is a similar time to when I started, he was on for a competition, and he's been a friend of the show ever since.
Day one, all right.
Very, very polarising. A lot of people love him. A lot of people hate him, but he's a good friend of mine on and off the air. He's annoyed that he hasn't been flowing up for this morning.
That is the reason he will not.
Right. He's a real hothead, but if he doesn't go on, he's going to regret this in days to come.
We're trying our best.
Has he still got his landline?
I believe so. We could try that.
Is he answering the landline? No.
Yeah, unless he's done that thing, you know, when you didn't want calls, you just take it off the hook. It. He might have done that.
We are texting him at the moment, and there are a lot of no's that have been sent
in back. Caps?
Caps lock
no's. Is he still sending you gifts?
Not me. He's blocked me, but Intern Cal's getting there.
Well, we want to get him back on sometime in the next hour and a half before the show ends. Hopefully we have Stephen from Dunedin on.
Okay, good luck getting him on. He's very stubborn.
I'm not going to miss this.
See you. Even when you're close, can't take the silence. We're good. 25 to 9, Dom, Meg and Randell. Dom's doing much better because he's got his dog in the studio. We have had a no dogs policy. I'm sure if you've been listening to the show for a while, you would have heard, you know, the passive aggressive ways that Dom's been trying to get his dog.
Oh, it is Fluffy Friday, though, but I didn't register him to come in this morning.
And he hasn't passed the woof test.
No,
but,
and I will say he's not on a lead and he is in the studio, so I'm breaking a lot of rules, but what's the worst that's going to happen?
What are they going to do, right? Hey, we got three people sitting on hold who want to come on and give you some well wishes, Dom, on your last day on the show.
Yeah.
There are three people who I think you have made overshare to the country when it's not their job, they didn't ask for it, and they don't get paid to do it.
Morning, Mum.
Good morning.
Oh, this is Meg's mum. Hello, Philippa.
Hello, Dom. Just wanted to say thank you very much for looking after my little girl. You and JJ just made her so, so welcome when she came to this to the Edge. And, yeah, God, you've made me laugh so many times. Made me cry, made me cringe. But, I'm really going to miss you, matey. Have a brilliant time ahead, whatever you do.
Oh, thanks so much, Philippa. Yeah, hopefully I see you around. And Meg's going to be great. She'll probably actually do better without me here because I can be quite overbearing and controlling and domineering.
Well, she'll only have one baby to look after now, so.
Jeez, that was a big truth bomb.
Thanks, Papa.
And you know what I'm not going to miss? Dom Harvey cracking onto my mum. Randall's mum has
got it going on. I'm going to have more time to crack onto your mum now.
Hi, Christine.
Hey, mum.
Hi, Dawn. Hi, everybody.
Hello, beautiful. How are you? You good?
Oh, very sad, Dawn.
Yeah.
I didn't want to come on the show because I didn't want to say goodbye.
Oh, your favourite member of the show is leaving. Yeah. Oh,
the one that makes me tell all my secrets.
Yeah. Hey, well, thank you, Christine, for like everything you've done on the last few years since Randall's been on the show. We really appreciate it, and you're an absolute rock star. And I'm sure you're going to be on the air just as much, just without someone on the show pesting on you.
Yeah, but you're the only one that can get the answers out of me. Nobody else can. Yeah.
I think I'd been on the show about 2 weeks when you needed someone to sub in for a listener for the Pocket Rocket Race. Racing vibrators down a track, and Mum was very willing. I think she won.
She even took some home in a goodie bag.
I've still got it too, Dom.
Okay, Mum. Oh, yeah. All right.
Maybe write my name on the side of that one in a vivid.
Thank you, Christine. I can't do anymore. And of course, the most important mum, morning, Sue.
Morning.
Hi, Mum. How are you coping this morning? You doing okay?
No, a bit sad.
Yeah.
I still want to get Sue's stories. They're my favourite.
Yeah, we can still get you on, Sue, even if Dom's not here.
Yeah. I felt I've been put in the corner now because I won't be on air anymore. My radio career is over.
No, yours isn't over with Dom. Yours will continue on with Meg and I.
Yeah. No, it'll be good. Mum, you'll see a new me over the next few months. We'll better go out for dinners and catch up a bit more. And I'm not always going to be stressed and tired.
I know JJ said something the other day and it resonated very well with me. She said that she's lucky to know the non-radio Dom, and I've missed that non-radio Dom because I know what you're like. So I just wish Meg and Randall all the very best. Thanks, Meg, Sue. I did send you a message, love.
Oh, no, I didn't get it. Oh, no.
Oh, maybe you've blocked it.
If I blocked you, I don't get it.
except a friend request, Meg.
Oh, God, maybe she sent it to the old Meg who's at ZM now.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I've got her phone this morning. What's this all about? All right. Hey, thanks.
No,
thanks,
Mark. You'll be good, Dom. Yeah. You're leaving with your head held high, and that makes me very proud.
Yeah.
Beautiful, Sue.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I always thought I'd be walked out of here where they take your swipe card off you. March you out by security.
We can set that up if you like. We can get some security in here and march you out.
Hey, thanks, Mum. I'll be seeing you soon. Thanks for all the support. Really appreciate it.
Love you.
You too. My parents, when I was like 14, 15 and decided I wanted to do radio, they never tried to like talk me out of it or anything, even though it's a very unconventional job. And even though I was like awkward and shy, as you guys know, I have a little bit of a stutter sometimes. I mean,
most times.
Most, yeah. But as responsible parents, they should have talked me out of it.
No.
But they didn't, and I'm pleased they didn't.
Jeez, out of all the mums, eh? Wow. Mum was the only one that cried. So, shows how much my mum cares compared to
how much she's in love with Dom.
I'm up here. I'm going to come around to your family dinners now.
You can Thursday nights, mate. All right, we're going to get into your scandal right after this. And then we have more special guests, including Dom's ex-wife, JJ, who was a huge part of the show.
Who invited her?
It's the end. She invited herself. I think you met me at a strange time and you angered me. I felt anonymous and you were someone who reminded me who I used to be. It had to break, I had to go, cause it took me walking away to really know. Sigrid and Mirror on the Edge. It's 13 to 9. Dom, Meg and Randell.
Scandal with Meg.
I tried to do a scandal, like, a special for Dom this morning and just talk about his favourite people, but there's nothing really going on with Bruce. Honestly.
Bruce Springsteen. Yeah, his daughter's at the Olympics.
Well,
you clearly don't have Google alerts out. His daughter's like an equestrian chick. She's at the Olympics.
I looked up what he was in the news for, and he has declined his name being tied to a rest stop in New Jersey. He doesn't want a toilet stop named after him. That's the best I can get. Oh,
well, fair enough, too.
What do you mean? It's like a legendary thing. Like, there's all these famous people. Like, Whitney Houston has one, John Bon Jovi, and he doesn't want one.
But would you want, like, a toilet named after you?
You would want it. Come on, if we get a cool toilet named
Do you want us to name the toilet here at work?
No.
The Dom Harvey rest stop.
No. It'd have to be the paraplegic one, because that's the one where I do my ablutions most of the time.
Wow.
It's the one where you get the most privacy. I've got a shy bladder.
It's not your bladder that you go in that bathroom But Lord has this morning been on a little YouTube show called Hot Ones, where you eat hot chicken wings while answering questions. She got asked a few New Zealand questions, what she thought about Hokey Pokey ice cream.
I like it, but I'm more preferential to a cookies and cream, which I know you have here, but I think of as like a very New Zealand ice cream.
And how she's obsessed with cheese like me.
I'm a bit of a cheese connoisseur. I love cheese, and kind of the zanier the better. Like, I've never met a cheese that was too funky and crazy for me.
And the thing that I found most weirdly impressive, she's a spice girl. No, you know what I mean.
What do you mean?
No, she likes spice. So normally Hot Ones, people get to a certain chicken wing, like they get up to like 7 out of 10, and they're like, I've got to tap out. They're crying, they're sweating. Hardly anyone has made it to the end. Lord made it to the final chicken wing that had like the bonnet Scotchville, like, highest that you could get. She just ate it casually. Listen to this.
Mmm. Yum. Get that bonnet.
Just enjoying. Just out here having lunch, Lord.
That was it. That was the final one. She's not sweating, not red, not crying. It was insane.
Is she a human?
I don't know. She was eating two chicken wings at once because it builds. It was just absolutely crazy. Who knew that she was such a badass with spice?
We've done that on the show as well in the past. Remember we got producer Chang to eat like the world's hottest chili?
There was actually
Yeah, that's right.
Something Reaper?
He was unreal. He was unwell for hours.
We had a million Scovilles.
We got sent a really, really, really hot sauce. Is that still here? Does anybody know? Producer Caitlin, I saw you eating a hot sauce yesterday. Is that still here? Oh, bugger. I could give that a go. Oh, it was really, really hot.
Don't want a shot of that on your last day?
No, thanks.
Oh.
Don't like inflicting pain, not receiving it.
Oh, we could give it a go, though.
Oh, producer Fipsy?
Yeah.
Can't hear.
Randell, do you want to do a shot of hot sauce for Dom's last day?
Yeah, we have a nice Tabasco that's sitting around in someone's locker if you guys want to give that a go.
Oh, it doesn't feel like the type of show for gimmicks, does it?
That's the latest scandal. Check out that Lord story on YouTube. It's Net Safety Week. Let's work together to make Aotearoa safer online. Head to netsafe.org.nz.
Okay, in just a few minutes, we are going to bring in the person who is the reason that Dom Harvey has been so successful and is even on the edge after she was given the job and said, I'm only coming if my boyfriend comes with me.
Amazing, what a boss.
Yeah, Dom's ex-wife JJ, who was a huge part of the edge, and I know when she left, it was a very similar feeling to today.
I feel like there's been more messages of love this morning than when JJ left after the same length of time.
Okay,
I mean, it's not, no one's keeping score.
Well, you are.
Sounds like it. All right, well, we'll take a break when we come back. Those who have been listening to the show for quite a while will remember JJ. She is joining us on the show before we get to 9 o'clock to share her messages of farewell to Dom. And let us know if the grass really is greener when you move on from the Edge.
We recently had Kate from The Office clean out the Edge promo cupboard.
Ooh, what's in here? Holy sh**. Are those your New Zealand vouchers? Wait, are those GHDs? Oh my God, this stuff is good. We need to give these away.
And that's exactly what we're going to do. Starting next week, both Edge Breakfast and Edge Afternoons will have 1 hour every day. Where every caller wins a prize out of our prize cupboard.
What the hell are these coffee machines doing in here? You know what? They've got to go.
Want to get in on the action? Save 0800 The Edge and your speed dial now. Who calls it speed dial? Save 0800 The Edge in your phone now. Every caller wins. First hour is 8am Monday morning.
The Edge. 94.2 The Edge. Traffic and weather.
NetSafe, keeping you safe online.
Fine today, some cloudy patches, possible showers, high of 17. Fine on our motorways, really quick into town everywhere. The southern is the heaviest, but it's only slow at Green Lane, really. 40 minutes dreary to the CBD, 25 in from Monaco. The northwestern flowing well, busy around Great North. 22 in from Massey and Northern fine, 20 minutes in from Constellation Drive. Minor delays on the southwestern.
Let's make Aotearoa safe online. Head to netsafe.org.nz for details.
A fresh blanket of powder, a cozy fireplace with great company. There's Snowplace, like a batch care holiday home this winter. Plus, the first 50 batch care bookings in Queenstown get a $100 Everything New Zealand voucher. Batchcare.co.nz. 10,
up to 10. 9, everything you could 8, ever want under $10. 7, more than 6, we can fit in 10 seconds, 5, but we'll try. 4, flowers, homewares, 3, cleaning products, stationery, 2, arts and crafts, 1, toys, 1, kitchenware. Oh, time's up. Up to 10. Westgate Shopping Centre.
Experience the best at Harvey Norman, official partner of Paralympics New Zealand. Get great deals on lounge suites, recliners, dining suites and more. Plus, get 60 months interest-free. Minimum purchase $490. See online for exclusions, fees, terms and conditions. Limited time only. Excludes outlet stores.
If I won $5 million, I'd build a mega corporate box.
Oh, yeah? Where?
At my kids' sports ground. No more standing in the rain.
Goodbye, gumboots.
Imagine winning $5 million this Saturday. Get your Powerball ticket today.
Hi, I'm Stephen Donald, and I'm proud to announce Bunnings Rugby Assist, an annual program helping local grassroots rugby clubs with vital facilities. Clubs could win up to $30,000 worth of products and materials from Bunnings. Entries close August 2nd. Enter now at bunnings.nzrugby.co.nz.
It's Pack and Save's birthday, so I, Super Birthday Man, am here to tell you about all their super birthday deals.
Meow.
No, kitty, I'm not saving you. I'm saving these listeners money, honestly. Super birthday deals on now at Pack and Save.
Meow.
Come on in for our renovation frenzy. Get up to 35% off modern pendants, up to 35% off mid-century styles, and up to 30% off luxury chandeliers.
Lighting Direct, proud partner of the Block NZ on 3.
Repco Stock Take Sale is now on with massive mid-year savings like 30% off car care and 30% off gear oil, brake fluid, auto transmission fluid and additives. This weekend only. Repco, it starts with the parts.
Auckland Light Rail is more than just a transport project. It's a foundation for growth. Access to more housing, jobs and public spaces will allow local economies and businesses to thrive. By bringing us greater access to our city, it will bring new opportunities to our communities. To learn how Light Rail will benefit your community and to share your views, visit lightrail.co.nz. Auckland Light Rail, bringing us closer.
It's Dom, Meg and Randell.
The Edge.
Good morning, it is 9 to 9. Dom, Meg and Randell for the final time today. Dom is wrapping up after just over 20 years on The Edge.
Oh, so many nice texts coming in on 3343. We haven't got to read many of them. How many do you reckon there are?
Over 5,000.
Yeah, it's amazing.
She always makes up numbers, eh?
I'm going to get them all printed out and I'll process them and read them over the next couple of weeks. But if you have texted, just know that it is going to be read.
Yeah.
Someone said, just in the bedroom with the husband, but I said I had to keep the radio on because I didn't want to miss any of the show this morning. Oh, this is nice. I've been a listener since the JJ, Mike and Dom days. My nan used to gasp at your questionable content. Now she's passed away, and I'm a mum with my own 8-year-old listening on our way to school. And to be honest, I'm surprised you never got asked to leave.
Well, speaking of the JJ, Mike and Dom days, JJ is joining us in studio this morning. Morning, babe.
Hello, guys.
Oh, wait, when did you leave and Meg took over? What was that, 5 years ago?
End of 2017, I think.
17. Okay, almost four years ago.
Three
and a half, yeah. Time flies when you're having fun, eh, Dom?
Yeah, it does. It does. Oh, it really does. When you were in exactly the same position. You were here like 20-something years, and the years just sort of roll into one. They sort of blur into one after a while.
Mm. But, well, you know, I got you the job on The Edge, right? Yeah. So now I'm taking you away, so.
Yeah. It's a crazy. Do you want to hear the story?
Yeah, I love the story.
We'll
go
to a song, and then we'll come back, and we'll find out how Dom actually managed to get his start on The Edge. And if it weren't for JJ, whether anyone would be sending in nice messages about Dom, because maybe he's not here at all.
Yeah. It's a hell of a yarn. It is worth pointing out, I did already have 10 years radio experience under my belt, so it wasn't just like, oh, my boyfriend's unemployed. Can he do radio?
But
Yeah.
hey, it's her story. Okay. Let her tell us. Right. Maroon 5, Megan Thee Stallion. We'll get to it right after this. Beautiful Mistakes, 9 to 9 at the edge. Beautiful, it's bittersweet. You're like a broken home to me. I take a shot of memories and black. I like an empty street. I fill my days with the way you walk and fill my nights with broken.
Situation's beneficial, doing something different, got me looking stupid. The only way I'm coming back to you is if you're dreaming, lucid, prove it. If you made a promise, then keep it. Why you wanna lie and then get mad? I don't believe it. But really, I was doing just fine without you. Looking fine, sipping wine, dancing, no club couches. Baby, why you wanna lose me like you don't need me? Like I don't block you and you still try to reach me. How you figure out how to call me from the TV? You running out of chances and this time I mean it.
Megan Thee Stallion, it's Beautiful Mistakes, 4 to 9, Dom Megan Randall, Dom's last day after 20 years on the edge, and we're all, I guess, guessing what we think he might be feeling, but the only one I think who really does know what Dom might be experiencing, because she's been through it herself, and she was on the show for many, many years, is Dom's ex-wife, JJ.
Morning, hello, babe. Hi guys. Hi, well you say ex, but we're still married.
You are still married.
Legally. It's a very unorthodox relationship.
I was thinking about it. It's kind of like an open marriage because we are still married. We still have to share the money and the dog, but we've got other lovers, so it works out well.
It's very...
Well, it does for me anyway.
I was going to say, does it work out well for the
so many lovers, so many.
It's very unusual, very complicated, but it's like what was working in the relationship we kept.
Yeah.
Didn't just like burn the whole building down.
Well, can we go right back to the beginning, JJ, of how Dom actually managed to get on the edge? Because a lot of people won't know how Dom got his start 20 years ago.
We told the listeners that he got fired for stealing toilet paper at his last job, but...
That was so early 2000s. You come up with a classic gag.
2001. So Dom and I were dating for like 2 years. He lived in Palmerston North, working for 2XS at the time with Mike West. And I was on the edge. And we were dating and we were thinking, how can we... Like, we're never going to be in the same city, you know, because you're in Palmy doing a great radio show there. I'm in Hamilton. I'm not leaving the edge. And our boss wouldn't have a bar of it either because he wouldn't get, you know, break up the show in Palmy.
But yeah, I was a big deal in Palmy.
He was. Yeah. Baldrick. Baldy.
That's right.
You had a different name.
Yeah.
So I got offered a job somewhere else.
ZM.
Yeah, and I said, I'll go if I can take my boyfriend. And they said yes, so we went to resign. And our boss, Stephen Joyce, said, oh, no way, no, oh, I don't like this idea, but all right, he can come and work with you, but it's not going to last.
Oh,
and he was right.
Yeah.
16 years later, he was like, I told you so.
Did he send the text?
No, he didn't.
Now, we've been trying to get somebody very special on the phone, so maybe it's just because you're in here, JJ, that he finally is answering our calls. Good morning, Stephen from Dunedin.
Well, good morning, guys, and I better be a bigger man, and yeah.
Yeah, Steve was a little annoyed that he wasn't flown up here for the final day.
What do you mean? What do you mean, Stephen? Be a bigger man?
I just want to have my final say and everything, and want to share a few memories about the show, because I've been part of the 20 years as well.
You have. You've been a big part. I told the story before how when the first week the Edge got switched on in Dunedin, you were one of the first callers we had, and you've been there ever since.
Yes, I have been and everything, and I follow now. I follow JJ to More FM.
Yay! Thanks, Stephen. In the afternoons, everybody, 3 to 7.
okay, calm your thumb.
Well, do you might have as well get a plug in there.
Yeah, Stevie, what do you say? Obviously, you and I are going to keep in touch, and we're friends, and not being on the radio is not going to change that. But what do you want to say? Say your piece.
Well, just want to say thanks for the memories anyway from the Edge and everybody, and there's so many memories that I could talk about and everything. Probably the biggest memory is with having the Jingle Bell trips and all the kids that share the memories with you and everything.
Yeah, anything in particular?
Oh, just all the rides and everything that we went on, and also the couple of memories to talk about the Jingle Bell trip is when we went to our favourite place, the King's Cross.
Oh yeah, I took Stephen to King's Cross.
Yeah, I love that story. Can you tell that story again?
Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah. What happened in King's Cross?
Yeah, you know what happened in there. We came across an uncertain woman, and she said, I said hello, and she said, oh, piss off, midget.
Right. That's not quite right. You asked her how much.
Yeah.
Is that the same one that fogged up his glasses?
And then we went into one of the clubs, and what happened in the club?
Yeah, my glasses got fogged up.
How did your glasses get fogged up?
You know why.
Yeah, so we were sitting right next to the stage, and then a lady there, she must have been very, very hot because she wasn't wearing any clothes. What did she do?
She took them off and put them up the butt.
What?
Oh my goodness.
All right.
And also, Dom.
Thank you, Steve.
Also, Dom.
Yes.
Dom.
Yes.
One more. And there's one more memory that we need to talk about. And it got everyone talking about. Remember one year, an April Fool's joke, we had a lady called April.
I don't remember this.
No. We had an April Fool's joke on the audience that Stephen was going to lose his virginity. And it was April 1st, but we'd said it was this place on K Road. We had the lady called April on who was going to take his virginity. Mm-hmm. And there were paparazzi that went out onto K Road to try and find this place.
April.
Yeah, the place that Stephen was supposedly going into. People were outraged. But then it sounded like they were getting it on, and Stephen was saying, oh, April Fool's.
Oh, that would have been good, Stevie. You would have got everyone.
It even made it in the news, didn't it, Stevie?
It did, really, yeah. So that's so many memories that we could talk about and everything. So thank you for the memories once again, Dominic, and good luck, and we'll keep in touch.
Yeah, thank you very much, Stephen, for everything you've done. You've been a big part of the Edge fabric.
Stephen,
we love you.
From Dunedin, thank you, brother. Appreciate you getting on the air this morning.
You leave the Edge, but you're not going to get rid of Stephen, Dom, and you ain't going to get rid of me either.
Hey!
And with our joint account, I brought us some champagne. So congratulations. I wanted to say some really nice things about you and stuff, but I feel like you guys have to go to the news or something.
We'll take a break. You can come back because, you didn't really. It looks, Stephen sort of stole your thunder. So we'll give you a chance, Jay, coming up.
You want me to say some nice things about Dom?
We'll take a break and then you can do that.
I'm definitely going to have to scull this back first then. I'll just take the bottle.
You're on the Edge. Dom, Megan, Randell, an hour to go.
Sharon and Jaden.
The Edge and Sharon and Jaden. Oh, gosh. Get out of here, Sagala. Oh, get out of here, Sagala. There we are. Oh, God. There we go. There we go. Wow, Sagala's a cheeky bugger, isn't he?
Yeah, he's always like, oh,
down there and I'm over there.
Oh my God, that was not me that time.
Sharon and Jada. 3 to 7 weekdays thanks to Mick Delivery.
Dreaming of cheeseburgers? Get Macca's delivered to your place.
The Edge.
94.2 The Edge. Traffic and weather.
Frame your memories with MasterFrame.
Weather okay today, mainly fine. Little scrappy at times, high of 17 degrees. Fine on our motorways into the city and roads looking fairly quiet as well. Just got some small delays for ferries this morning due to a bit of fog. Check the Fuller's website and you'll be all right. Southern Motorway, 25 minutes. Manukau to the city, just a bit busy at Green Lane. Northwestern, 22 and from Massey, fine. And Northern Southwestern, really good.
For all your photo and print framing, do it with MasterFrame. Preserving lifetime memories.
Being out of the office shouldn't mean being out of data. Get your team of 5 to 100 on a mobile plan that gives them the freedom to keep working pretty much anywhere for only $38 per person per month. Search Vodafone Business Team Plan. Price excludes GST. Terms apply.
Try something new and try building a hardwood table.
Laminated clear pine panel, only $123.
Will you find a competitor's lower price on the same stocked item? We'll beat it by 15%. Get it done this DIY July.
Making better choices is a whole lot tastier with Peter Pitt. When it comes to your body, they know that fueling it with great foods means that you can be at your best. That's why in their locally owned and operated stores nationwide, you'll find only the best natural fillings and ingredients sourced from local farmers, bakers and artisans. There's something for everyone, from tasty pitas and scrumptious salad bowls to a kids menu and a wide range of snacks. Try it for yourself. Order online now at peterpitt.co.nz.
For the broad range of job opportunities that other job sites just don't have, go to My Jobspace. Employers and job hunters are searching at My Jobspace, the launch site for every Kiwi career. MyJobspace.co.nz.
Digital marketing, websites, data, analytics. Start with ThatWeb, one of New Zealand's most experienced digital marketing companies. Effective, affordable and guaranteed BS-free. If image is a big part of your business, go to fatweb.co.nz.
Experience the best at Harvey Norman. Huge deals on TVs, audio and home appliances. Plus, buy on 60 months interest free and receive a bonus Harvey Norman gift card up to $500. Minimum financed amount $1,000. See online for exclusions, fees, terms and conditions.
Hey, Auckland Council's Waitakere Refuse and Recycling Transfer Station is your go-to for commercial waste. We have sharp unloading speeds to help you out and a commitment to diverting waste from landfill. Stop by and talk to our friendly staff today. 50 The Concourse, Henderson.
Let your taste buds loose at Shed 10. Street Eats 2021. A multi-level food and music festival experience with pop-up kitchens, bars, craft beers, boutique spirits and a huge DJ lounge featuring Sweet Mix Kids, Weird Together Sound System, Rooms, DJ Belleville and DJ Forge. Plus eclectic live performances. Your recipe for a good time. Street Eats on now at Shed 10. Tickets from $20 at the door.
Just Dom, Meg and Rando.
Morning, it's 9:05 at 3 through till 10. We always get into a DJ Sean Hill mix on a Friday as we celebrate the 20 plus years that Dom has been at the Edge. It's his last day today. JJ's here to say some nice things to him. He's not even in the room.
Oh, God, that's probably even better, actually. I can just tell you some real stories about him then, some gossip.
He's running.
Oh, he's so lovely, like I'm really going to miss him. He's so.
what have I missed?
Nothing.
You've been on there 27 seconds. What happened?
Nothing, but I made poured you a bubble, so
thank
there you.
You
go.
Thank
Enjoy.
You.
Yeah, thanks, JJ.
Were you invited in this morning? Or
no, I asked if I wanted to come in.
All right. Why don't you get so nervous whenever she's in there?
Yeah, I know, I love it.
Da-da-da. I'm like haunting you, eh?
You really are.
Well, we've been joking around, but I know you've come in to also say, you know, some nice things and be honest with how you...
Oh, you want me to do it now?
Yeah, go on.
Oh, okay. Well, I hadn't planned anything, but I just want to say you're awesome. No, I'm only joking.
Well, thank you.
It's actually been quite an emotional morning listening to you say goodbye to everybody. And I must admit that Paula and Zane, two strangers in a wedding who we married in 1999.
Oh, you did. That was before I started.
Yeah, he made me cry. Far out. He's a good guy. You know, there's been... You're very talented and you've got me in a lot of trouble over the years.
I'm sorry about that. Very stressful when we're married. She was always lumped in with me. Like if I did something on the air that got in trouble, it was always like JJ and Dom.
It was never JJ Mike and Dom or JJ Dom and Randall, was it? No. Always Randall got away with it too. No. Look, people, what they really, really don't know about you is you're quite sensitive and you're actually a really caring person, even though it sounds like you don't care on the air. But I think that you've got this bravado because you don't want people to see that you're sensitive and sweet. So you outwardly, you know, mock and take the mickey. And when anyone says something nice to you, you always end with a killer punch, right? Some sort of funny...
deflection.
Wow. Deflection, yeah. And I mean, I just hope that this time that you take off your... you'll start to come to like the real you. Sorry.
It's all right. Come on.
When you come back.
Dom, no deflecting.
Sorry. Yeah. I'm just going to tell you we're live. We can't edit this out.
When you come back, because you'll come back and... you'll be a better broadcaster, I think, because
impossible.
I think you can't come back. You'll impossible. Come back as you, Dom, as you. And you're actually a really amazing person. Everyone who knows you loves you, and everyone who knows you says these things about you. So to anyone who you've ever pissed off over your career, and that's a lot of people, okay. I know that you always felt bad afterwards. And I hope that they can forgive you and just know that you're so passionate about your job and entertaining people, and all you care about is getting laughs from other people, even at some people's expense.
Yeah, generally mine and Meg's,
But hey, Dom really does care, and you're very good at what you do, and I just really, I know you need this break, and it's going to be good for you, so I'll be there to pick up the dog sometimes when you're out for your five-hour runs, and... Anyway,
I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Man, do you guys want to get back to Kiss?
No.
Come on.
No.
Guys, all my boyfriends are going to be so jealous if I do that.
No, we've got a great thing. A lot of people break up, and for whatever reason, the whole relationship can't exist. But we've kept the good stuff of our marriage, and it's a relationship that I'm just so, so grateful for to have you in my life. You're my best sounding board. Just my best friend. And thank you. Thank you so
I'm
much.
I'm kind of like the listeners this morning. I've forgotten all the bad stuff.
Surprisingly easy to do.
And what JJ was saying, to anyone I've pissed off over the years, I apologise. Nothing's ever been done in malice. Even staff that have worked on the show that I've pissed off, I apologise. I've got very, very high standards when it comes to the radio show. I work people very hard, but I would never get anyone to do anything that I wouldn't do myself, or get anyone to work as hard as what I would. But if you're one of those people that's listening saying, who's JJ talking about? What are all these nice messages? They don't know the real him. I apologise if you've had a bad experience with me.
Well, congratulations to 20 years at the Edge. It's a pretty big milestone for anyone to be 20 years anywhere. And good luck, Meg and Randell, what you guys do next, and good luck for your baby coming up.
Thanks.
And I'll just be down the hall anyway. Yeah. I'm in the building. Cheers, guys.
Cheers to Dom Harvey. Thank you, JJ. Alright, we get into the mix. We keep celebrating Dom for the next hour. You're on the Edge.
Better than yours, I can teach you. But I have to judge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours, damn right. It's better than yours, I can teach you. But I have to judge. Warm it up, la 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 la. The boys are waiting.
crazy shit I did tonight. Those will be the best memories. I just wanna let it go for tonight. That would be the best therapy for me.
We dipping in a pot of blue flow. Getting so good, it's dripping. I don't would get a ride in that engine that could go. Batman robbing it, bang bang cocking it. Queen Nikki dominant, prominent. It's me, Jesse and Ari. If they test me, they sorry. Riders up like a Harley, then pull off in this Ferrari. If he hanging, we banging. Phone ringing, he slanging. It ain't karaoke night, but get the mic cause I'm singing. B to the A, to the N, to the G. B to the A, to the N, to the G. Hey. Just confess your girl admits that we the shit. F-R-E-S-H, we fresh. G-E-F, that's right, we def. We definite. B-E-P, we reppin' it. So, turn me up. Turn me up. Turn me up. Come on, baby, just pump it. DJ
Psycho, I'm libo to go Michael. Take your pick, Jack
Jason, Tyson, Jordan, game six. Falls so hard, got a broke clock. Rollies that don't tick tock. All the Mars that's losing time, hitting behind all these big rocks. Falls so hard, I'm shocked too. I'm supposed to be locked up too. You escape, but I escape. You be in Paris, get messed up too. Falls so hard, let's get faded. Liberties for like 6 days. Gold bottles, soul models, still an ace on my sick days. Falls so hard, behave. Just might let you meet, yay. Shot towns, B-Rolls, moving the next.
Live in the mix with each DJ.
Baby, can't you see I'm calling? A guy like you should wear a warning. It's dangerous. I'm falling. There's no escape.
So we've just been partying here in studio as the DJ Sean Hill. Edge Friday Mix, you can get those on the Rover app if you want to stream them. We've got a bit of a party going on here in studio in the morning. At the moment. Morning, guys. Whole bunch of the Edge crew hanging out here dancing. We're all dancing, partying, and drinking orange juice, of course. And Dom was head down in his computer working.
So... Mate. He's never enjoyed our dance parties.
No, no, everyone comes in here. The lights are dim. Randall's pretending to be a DJ.
Yep.
The music's obnoxiously loud. I'm just... I'm too old for this shit.
Alright, well, we are going to continue to celebrate Dom for the next 40 minutes until we wrap the show up for Dom's final show for the Dom, Meg and Randall show on the Edge. But I imagine things are going to get very emotional between here and then. And Dom's final voice break, have you prepared something? Or are you just going to freestyle it?
No, I feel like it's probably best to go from the heart.
Yeah, cool.
I don't know. I feel like the last couple of days I've said everything that needs to be said.
Well, just make sure you keep it under 4.5 minutes.
Oh, yeah, that's true. You don't want people texting in, go shut up, play music. First of all, I thought you were a radio station.
Blue song.
We get that a lot.
If you do want to check out the live stream, you can text the word watch to 3343 and we'll send you a link so you can see what's going on behind the scenes because it is a bit of a party vibe at the moment as we celebrate the 20 years Dom has been on the Edge. Doja Cat and Scissors, Kiss Me More, 23 past 9. Dom, Meg and Randall on the Edge.
Kiss me, boy. We're so young, boy. We ain't got nothing to lose.
you lost without me. All my shorties feel like I dodged the county. Coughing with you feel like jail, buddy. I can't even exhale, buddy. Cookie like holy grail, you know that. You gon' make me need bail, you know that. Caught dipping with your friend. You ain't even had man lying on your you know that. Got me a bag for the brick, you know that. Control them so the pace it right though back. All this cash for real.
Over the car, so lonely. Over the car.
Sharon, Castle on the Hill. It is 9:30 on the Edge, another 30 minutes of the Dom, Meg and Randell show.
It's been an extremely emotional morning, and there have been a lot of tears through the text machine, through the callers. Dom has cried. JJ, Dom's ex-wife, came in before and cried a lot. Sorry, cried a lot too.
Was that a burp?
Yeah, were you emotional when you got choked up?
No, I was emotional.
And I have also...
I've cried quite a bit over the past few days.
Yeah, one person on the show hasn't. Hey, you're just being brave.
We thought that
Your mum cried.
Yeah, yep. No. I teared up when it was on Wednesday. I think when you were talking about
what the show meant to you.
It's not about me though. I don't need to make sure everyone hears it.
I've worked with you longer than Meg as well. Mm-hmm. So, there's so many nice texts as well coming in, and thank you very much. 3343 is the number if you want to text. We haven't read many of them out. There's been like in the thousands, I'd say, but I'm going to get them printed out and read them over the next couple of weeks.
Cool.
To help the tears come along, and since you are in need of a punishment from Dry July, we have a little sauce called Brutality.
Megan, it's not the time.
Can you show me the label? What else does it say? Dom. What does it say? It's Brutality, our hottest sauce yet.
Okay. And then maybe we'll get some tears out of him, Dom.
Oh, jeepers, it hurts my nose just putting it near my face.
Would that make
you feel better, Dom, or would you rather just like hear nice things?
Well, I just sniffed a little bit of it. It clears out your sinuses, doesn't it?
Oh, shivers.
Oh, no, I just want you to cry, really.
Yeah.
Do you want to take it in the mouth, no, or should I rub it on your gooch?
No. Mate, I can cry if you want. I'm an actor.
I can bring it on.
I saw the movie you were in. It wasn't that great.
One and done.
That was a tiny spoon. I think he needs it.
Oh, shit. I mean, sorry. Oh, shivers.
Is that enough, or does he need like a gulp from the bottle?
It's up to you, Joe. It was your last day.
Oh, no, that feels like that's enough.
Ooh, yeah, if you've just joined us, Randall's just had a tiny spoonful of a sauce by Cully's called Brutality.
Oh, it really continues to like warm up inside your mouth.
Have you had
still
enough?
Still no tears. No, Dom, I don't see a single tear.
Do I need to rub it in his eyes?
I don't see a single tear.
Well, while that continues to build and the tears continue to come, can we look back on one of the memories? We've been looking back at some highlights. Whew.
You had the tiniest amount.
Such a small amount.
One of the producers just bought in a 2-litre bottle of Anchor milk. No, you can have as much milk as what you had that sauce.
There are a lot of people with a lot of memories of Dom. This is one that probably a lot of people won't remember, but it was a random thing that happened, I think, quite early in the morning.
This is one of my favourite memories on the show.
Meg had a lot of fun punishing Dom and giving him a giant wedgie. Yeah.
How did this come about?
Because I said it was a dream that to give somebody a wedgie and pull their undies off, and you brought in your holy undies for me to do it.
Right, right. Oh, that's right.
Okay. Here we go. You got to say the mean things first.
All right. Oh, You little wuss, how do you like that?
You're
getting
a wedgie!
Oh my god! Oh my god!
Meg is loving
it. You mean on the guy? Hang on. Okay, I'm gonna come in like a bully. Look at you, big nerd!
Wow, they're just about gone. Did you want to do the last?
Oh yeah! Get him, mate! Get him!
Here we go. Your mum's hot.
They were that rotten.
Right, well, you can just literally rip them off with your hand. That's so overdue, bro. She loved watching you in pain.
Did you want to give me a little wedgie? Just a short one.
No, I don't. Okay, I don't want to give you a wedgie.
Okay,
sure, you don't want to rip the pregnant woman's undies off?
Yeah. I've started to realise, when I first started The Edge, anything would go, and that sort of like filter's got more narrow and narrow and narrow. And now things like before, when Randell suggested I take a poo on the boss's desk and giving you a wedgie, I just don't have it in me anymore.
It's all gone.
It's time for a change.
Yeah, I got you a potty from Kmart. It's not like it's going on the desk. It's just the act.
Yeah, but you still wanted me to like defecate in the office. It's an open plan office. That was weird.
The old Dom would have
done
it.
You should have more sauce.
Still not one tear. Here you go. Not one tear. Unbelievable.
Say something emotional.
He's going to feed you one proper spoonful because we're not getting one tear out of you, and it's really actually disturbing that you're not even going to cry.
It's actually quite disturbing. I promise you, I will cry before the end
one,
of the show.
One, two, three.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Dominic. I'm not going to miss you.
If you don't cry, I'm getting a soup spoon. Then we're going to the ladle.
Okay.
how long do I have to cry? Oh my God, oh my God.
Unbelievable. It reeks of a lack of respect, doesn't it?
Doesn't care
no
at
tears.
All.
It's almost like you're happy.
Not one tear.
It's almost like you're happy I'm going. I feel like staying just to spite you now. Oh no,
so
the fake. That's so fake. That's
he's
the worst acting
so
ever.
Hard to cry.
I'm sorry, you're going to have to do better than that. Producers, get the soup spoon.
Oh my gosh.
Coming up next, Randall's going to have a soup spoon of the hot sauce.
Oh no, I will cry during the song. I'll cry during the song. It's building.
Do I need to rub it on directly on the testicles?
Look, look, it's coming.
No, it's really not. Okay,
it's not coming
this,
at all.
Text watch the 3343. Not one tear. I've never been so disrespected in my life, and it's not
rude.
Even me.
It's rude. It's rude. That's the only word for it.
Don't make a Randall for 24 more minutes.
With a safety bin, you and I, we got so high, kissed like heroin. Where do I begin? We had that young love, we had that dumb love, the kind that caught you up inside my blood was your love. We had that you jump and I'm jumping, crazy kind of something that dumb love. We had that young love.
We have a tier.
21 to 10.
I feel like it's still not, it's not genuine though. Like, look, he's doing that thing where you're like,
he's kept his eyes open that entire
yeah,
song.
Yeah, so it's just like, no.
I'm crying.
Not good enough.
Wait, the final breakdown, at the moment I'm just trying not to think about it. 6 years of my life I've had to work alongside you.
Part of me thinks you're happy I'm going.
That's what it would look like if he's not crying.
Unbelievable. Well, unbelievable.
When you leave, who becomes the top dog?
Your name's still not going to be first, bro.
And oh, my first name.
Yeah, Randall said the other day in a meeting, since Dom's leaving and we're having a rebranding, can I go back to using my name Clint instead of my family name?
He was thinking about himself again after we
Yeah, unbelievable.
It was half a joke. Half joking.
So many nice texts coming in on the 3343. God, I'm going to look forward to reading these in the future.
Do you want me to read some for you instead of you having to read it?
Okay, it feels a bit weird.
Okay.
A bit self-indulgent.
Dear Dom, you can be so proud of yourself as you have made such a positive impact on so many lives. I'll never forget the 5 marathons in a row. What a legend you are. Good on you for taking a break to look after yourself. I have done the same and I've really grown from it. You will be missed by all of us, but life is short and you should enjoy it and you reserve it. Love from Nelson.
Mm. Although I tend to disagree. Like if you get a full lifespan, it's actually not that short. You realise there's quite a bit of time.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm one of many listeners who have been a school run listener.
Run is like 8 to 8.30. That's when we get told off for our content.
I would also take a couple of other kids in my car too. Suffice to say, I've had to quickly hit the off button a couple of times. Sometimes I've gulped at what comes out of your mouth, but geez, you're freaking awesome. Amazing broadcaster who shared with the listeners many of your own personal moments. You've made us cry at times, but most importantly, you've given us laughter. Go well, and you good man, and I look forward to reading the next chapter of your life. Thanks for the memories.
Oh, that's so nice. Where are the callers, by the way? Producer Fipsy. My mate Luke just messaged me on Instagram saying I've been trying to get through for 4 hours. I started to think no one wants to talk to me on my last day.
Is that Luke Forrest?
Yeah, yeah, here he is.
Oh, yeah, he's there.
I'm here. I'm Luke.
Hey, morning, Luke.
G'day, Dom. Yo.
4 hours he's been trying. You need to get a life.
Obviously, I don't have a life because I drive a bloody truck. So.
Okay. All right, 4 hours it's taken you to get through. What did you want to say? What do you want
to... I just wanted to say, Dom, top job over 20 years. I've been listening since I was a young fella. And I've been harassing for the last year to come climb a mountain. I'm still waiting. So let's do this.
All right.
Well, you've got time. You can't say no now. You can't be
She's
like,
got
well,
no
got
excuse
work.
Now to get out of that sort of stuff.
So that's uncomfortable.
Hey, I've been saying that to people. I've been saying to my sister, hey, listen, I've been a crap uncle because I'm so highly strung and this job is quite stressful and I work very hard.
Yeah.
I'm horrible to myself, and I'm a bit of a perfectionist. I said to my sister, listen, any weekend the kids want to go to Rainbow's End, I'm there.
Wow.
And I've told some friends of mine, and they laugh at me, and they say, no, you still come up with an excuse not to do it.
yeah, it'll take a little while, I think.
I think Meg and I will probably need to say our temporary farewell, I suppose, because the final break will be yours and your stage, and I don't think we should be overshadowing it with what we want to say. So maybe we're running out of time to do that now, but I've been doing breakfast radio across a few different stations for about 12 years, and half of that has been with you. I'll admit, when I first met you and JJ for coffee to kind of see if we were going to vibe, I was a ZM listener, so I didn't really know you were a big deal at first, but I'd heard some stuff.
Unbelievable.
And honestly, like, the first few months was a real crash course for me, trying to work out where my place in the show was, but also just I realized how much I was learning off you, like, so quickly. Like, I felt like I kind of knew what I was doing, and then I started working with you and I was like, wow, this guy plays on like another level. And there is, I think, a lot of anxiety from myself and Meg amongst the celebration, being like the show going on next week without you. It's like you've been you've been the only part of it that's been consistent the entire time. So to keep that legacy going, I feel like there's a lot of pressure. And for myself and also for Meg to step up, because I think behind the scenes people don't realize how much of an immense role that you play in the show and so many of the incredible ideas that we do that people talk about. It's like, yeah, that was a Dom idea. That was a Dom idea. And it's just, the shoes are so massive, man, to fill. And I think sometimes the pressure, maybe when we think about it too much, can get to us, because so often I think we've allowed you to keep carrying that slack because you love it, you enjoy it, you thrive on it. And I just think sometimes all the laughs and the comments that you make on the air, and you rip people up, and people just think that's all there is to you. And it's really just the tip of what you do for the show. I've never met anyone who has a level or a standard as high as yours. And sometimes maybe that offends people because you expect the best. And I think that's why...
That's why we go through 4 producers a year.
Been through... It's been so successful.
God,
so,
you talk a lot. Can you wrap it up?
No. Meg, I agree. He does talk a lot, but I'm loving this.
Oh, you're loving this part. Okay. Well, I have to do my bit next.
Yeah. So, I just... And then I think about the fact that even though there is anxiety in that we've been alongside you and you have... imparted so much into us as broadcasters, and then I think we'll be fine because I feel like we've been sponges working with you, and we've absorbed everything that we can, and we can't be you and we won't be you, but the show I think will continue to be steered in the right direction because of the way that you've sort of taught everybody, even unknowingly, with the certain things that you do. You know?
Oh, thank you so much. I've got absolutely no doubt you guys are going to be fine. We've got fantastic producers and a fabulous team, and that's why I feel like the time is right. And to anyone that's listening right now, the Edge family, this is a fantastic station, and it's a fantastic place to work, and we've got a great team here. And I'd urge you to keep listening. And, you know, it's a transition period, but stick with it and give it a go, because these guys, Meg and Randell, are great. And the show's going to be... And we're a family here. It's a family.
Yeah. All right, Meg, do you want
to... Oh, no, we're running out of time for me. Yeah, no, nobody wants to hear the ladies speak.
Obviously, I got to play a song.
And Meg can get her own break next.
Yeah.
I don't need that long.
That was 7 minutes, but it was good. I hung off every... It was the first time I listened to a random story without picking my phone up.
that's not very far from the truth. Joel Corey, MDK, it's hitting hard on the edge.
Oh my God, this feeling's just begun. I'm saying things I've never said, doing things I've never done. Oh my God, when I see you, I should it right. But I'm frozen in motion, and my head tells me to stop. Tells me to stop feeling I feel about us. Try to fight it, but it's never enough. My heart is hurting, it's more than a crush. Cause I'm frozen in motion, and my head tells me to stop. But my heart goes tells me to stop feeling I feel about us. Try to fight it, but it's never enough. My heart is hurting, it's more than a crush. Cause I'm frozen in motion, and my head tells me to stop. But my heart goes
second to last song, Joel Corey, MNEK of the Dom Megan Randell Show. It is 11 to 10. The studio is starting to fill up with some staff members.
Oh, morning, team.
Morning.
Yeah, this is lovely. Yeah, everyone get in here. The more the merrier. By the way, during the song Head and Heart, Meg was writing some bullet points for my speech. Good to see you didn't sit down last night.
I'll tell you what I was writing down. I don't want to cry, so I've written down all the things that I didn't like that you did to me. Just
okay, I'll go.
There's a different spin on it. All right. Floor is yours, Meg.
No, Dom Harvey is the most unique friend I've ever had in my life, and I think a lot of people would be able to say that in this weird way that sometimes I've like literally wanted to rip your head off, and like throw it into an ocean.
And like, wow, that's specific. And
an like, entire chain and a weight to it so it sinks.
But then somehow like 20 minutes later, we're like laughing about something again. And I said this morning, you've taught me very much so. And I think you've improved my life in a bigger way than this show of being able to let go of anger really easily because I know there's no malice behind what you're doing to me. You're such an entertainer. Like the time that you told everybody that I shit the bed when I was really, really sick.
Oh, yeah, and now that's called doing a Meg.
Yeah,
it's even on Urban Dictionary. Yeah. Look it up.
When you wore my underwear on a live stream.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, I was pretty angry about that one. Yeah. When you set up the interview with the guy who had sex with the dolphin.
Oh, yeah, how good was that? The guy in Florida. He actually did. He wrote a book about it, too.
Yeah, he did.
They changed the law because of him.
Because he was...
It wasn't illegal because they thought no one would ever do it.
So you have all these like amazing stories that like now I'm at a place in my life that I do look back and laugh. But at the moment, like I was like, he winds me up so much. Oh, the time that we gave up my phone number on here. God, I was wound up then. Remember?
Oh yeah, you were wound up.
I was pretty mad.
She was so mad.
I was very mad, and I blamed you, even though it was the wheel's fault. No, it's a funny relationship because you. It's hard not to love you, even though you have done things that nobody else would have done to me. But I know it's for this job. And I know behind the scenes, and everyone said it that knows you very well, behind the scenes, you have always been the first person to text me or call me if you know I actually am in trouble or need help, or the first person to buy me flowers on any sort of congratulations. Still waiting for yours, Randall, by the way, I'm the baby.
I didn't want to overshadow Dom's gift.
Okay. He's so generous, but so being tight.
No, and like I am genuinely excited for you in that whatever you're going to do next, you're going to be able to do it on a full sleep, which, I mean, we don't even know what that's like for you yet.
Yeah.
Everything that you have ever done, you've put so much passion into that I have no doubts of whatever you do next, it's going to be phenomenal. And who knows what that's going to be, whether you are going to be the next Olympic swimmer, since you're beginning into that, or where are you going to go with your runs, or if you're just going to start a travel blog so you can make everyone jealous.
That's a good idea. No one's doing a travel blog, right?
That's a good idea. Yeah,
or an Instagram page where you document your travel journeys.
But yeah,
it's a good idea. Maybe a podcast as well. No one's doing that.
You won't lose that drive, mate. Your greatest fear is being poor.
Your passion has been so poured into this one job that the fact that this is now away from you, I mean, it's a cliche saying, but the world is your oyster, and I can't wait to see what you put your next amount of love and passion and dedication that you have in the past few years to. And you know how grateful I am to you being open to having me after your wife JJ left the show, which was the scariest, biggest shoes to fill, which I now know somebody else is also. Wait, I'm going to read defecated bed. That's right. I'm just not going to cry.
Doing the meg. Embrace the actual name.
That I know somebody else is going to have that pressure to fill your shoes, which is an immense amount, but you always made me feel like it was possible, and you've always made me feel like I'm a good broadcaster, which I'm not very natural at understanding. So thank you. It still hasn't quite set in for me. I think that's why I'm able to hold it together, and I don't know if it's quite set in for anyone else that you're not going to be coming back, but I just hope that you're happy in whatever you do next.
Thank you. That's beautiful.
All right.
is this it?
Do you want to play, we'll play one more song and then you can come back and get the final word.
Okay, we'll be running a bit late, but is that what you want to do?
Yeah. Do you want to do it now? Or do you just want to? What do you
want to go.
You want to go?
Yeah, sure. Okay, play another song.
Okay.
There's a lot of people in here. I know they've got jobs to do.
All right. Probably quite fitting for the last song before Dom gets the final say. 660 and the greatest.
Oh, the goat.
Dom Megan Randell on the edge. Reminds me of all of the years and the dreams I've been chasing. Fueling the fire inside so the fears I can face. Cause mama never told me nothing about being complacent. So you can knock me down, but I won't stay on the ground. Can't stop believing. Just a little more.
makes it worth it all. When I hear the call, will I rise or fall? I know all my roads lead to something gold, so I will walk them all. I will walk them all. You can knock me down, but I won't stay on the ground. To keep on us, keep pushing harder. Can't stop believing I'm the greatest. Hearts breaking till I know I made it. I'll never know what second place is. No pain, no doubt.
No pain, no doubt.
Till the lights go out. Let's go out.
660 and the greatest, as requested by Dom.
That is true. I'd like to say it's not, but there's an email trail.
Couldn't be more fitting, mate. All right, well, this is the final break of the Dom, Meg and Randell show, and the room is absolutely packed with friends and co-hosts and workmates. I don't think we get too many more in here, so, mate, we're going to pass the... floor over to you, and you get the final word.
Well, Sharon just came up to me and said, I have to swear. What? What's the swearing? Why do I have to swear?
Oh, can you not say that when our bosses are in the room?
What's the swearing
there was
thing?
There was an Edge tradition that started when Brad left the night show, is once you finish your final break and the anchor says the Edge, you have to say, peace out, mother... And that's how it ends.
Is that a tradition?
Brad's done it.
The head of broadcasting says no.
Brad's done it. Brad's done it. Marty's done it. Steph's done it. Guy's done it. Clint's done it. John and Ben were too pissed. So
one last BSA complaint. Go
come on. It's like we got 6 months on. They won't remember.
Well, you get to do one final sign off, and then we'll see whether you're a pussy or not.
Okay.
Well, come on. Don't make this the one break you're a pussy.
Okay. Well, and cut the sad music for just a second. Well, in the words of Leonardo DiCaprio, I'm not leaving. I'm not fucking leaving! The show must go on!
I'm not leaving. I'm not leaving.
I'm not fucking leaving! I don't really know what to say. I didn't write anything down. I probably should have. It's been a very emotional last couple of days. When you get the chance to, put a bow on your... time at a radio station, you realise just how much love there is out there, and it's been incredible. And there's been so many text messages and so many DMs and texts the last couple of days, so I'm going to get them printed out and read them in my own time in the next couple of weeks. It's going to take a lot of time to process, what's been going on, but I just want to say thank you very much to everyone at The Edge in the past 20 years. Some of them are no longer with us. They passed away. Some of them no longer speak to me anymore. But it's just a fantastic team. And if you're listening to this, I know there's going to be some changes going on. But I'd urge you to stick with The Edge, because it's a family rather than a station. And if you're listening to this right now, you're part of that family. Meg and Randell, it's been absolutely wonderful working with you for the sort of last chapter of my career, I guess. And you guys are going to be fantastic. You'll probably shine a bit more without the shadow of me standing in the way.
What?
I probably represent an old Edge time, and it's time to move on. Close that door and move on. But you better still do some outrageous stuff and push some boundaries. If you're not pissing people off, you're doing something wrong. Promise me you'll piss people off.
Promise.
I don't know if I believe you guys.
Yeah, promise.
Thank you so much to everyone. I hope you understand the reasons. I just need like a little bit of time just to catch my breath, catch some sleep, and chase some personal goals outside of work. Mm. It's a very, very strange job, this one, in the respect that you put so much of yourself out there. And I've been doing this since I was 17 years old. I decided when I was about 13 that I wanted to be on the radio. Then it became a goal when I was 17. So for my entire sort of adult life, I haven't been a normal person. I've been an on-the-air person. So I just need a few months just to process and take some time for me, and then I'll come back. As I've said a couple of times this week, I consider it like a halftime break. So, the first half is over. Have a break, and then I'll come back and do something new, when the time feels right. But to the Edge listeners, thank you so much. You are the people that have made this journey fly by. I never thought I'd stay here 20 years, but it's just all sort of rolled into one. You guys are the reason that we do what we do every day. And I know it sounds fun and it sounds easy, and for the most part it is, but there's also like hard work and a lot of pressure and expectations behind that. But you're the reason everyone on the station gets out of bed every morning and gives it 100% to try and entertain you guys, and thank you very much. I think that's about all. I don't know what else there is to say. I feel like I'm out of tears. I think I've cried more in the last couple of days than what I've cried in the last decade, if I'm being honest. But it's been a wonderful, wonderful journey. And I mean, regrets, there's a few, but not many, if I'm being honest. Nothing that stands out compared to all the highlights. So thank you very, very much. Love you guys. And for the last time, this has been Dom Harvey on The Edge. Peace out, mother effers.
Want more Dom, Meg and Randell? Get the podcast on our free app Rover. And everywhere else you get your podcasts.